very bright. She very happy. So, no, happy with her. At the time, you know, I thought, oh, well, there's another group one gone because, you know, last year we had COVID. But, you know, as it turned out, going to Te Rapa on Saturday has probably sort of played into our hands a little bit. We're going to get a better track because as that track turned out just before then, when I had a look at it, when they called them off, I don't know whether we would have handled that ground. Oh, races are all different. I mean, depends on, say, what's in it, where the speed comes from. You know, you can analyse things and, you know, make all the plans, but they can be thrown out the window in the first 10 strides. So, you know, it's just up to the jockey then.
And for her, where does this race fit in the preparation? Is this the grand final, or is there something else to come?
No, it was always going to be a grand final. She was always going to either go to Sydney or go to the Breeders and then go out. So it's just her swan song for the year. She's only four. She's done a great job. She's come a long way, and so she can go and have a good rest, come back in the spring.
When will we see her next, you know, come the spring?
Oh, I don't know. We'll just play that one by ear. Depends on weather and things like that. But, no, she'll appear somewhere in the spring. How early, I don't know. It just depends on how I've got to sit down with the owners and work out a program for the spring, but we'll get Saturday out of the way first.